Hey guys, it's your boy Kabirza, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off, I completed Season 4, by winning the FA Cup and winning the Champions League to complete the quadruple of the League, FA Cup, Capital One Cup, and Champions League. The set was done, and now a new season begins. First game is an away game at the Bowling or her Upton Park. Against the Hammers, West Ham. And it's quite fitting that it's an actual away game that Liverpool are actually wearing the away kit, because it actually happens to be I'm actually wearing that same kit myself. Oddly enough, didn't plan that, but hey, that's how it worked out. So, you can see the team, no changes. I'm trying to think. I don't think I've even made a sign yet in this transfer window. If I have, he wasn't very important. Although Desciglio did leave, so that just means Prestius is gonna get more games. So good for him. But no one's come in. No one has come in. Now, last season was my, by far the worst season I've had of all four, with, several cases of dropped points, so, the goal for this season is to avoid dropping points for as long as possible.
We're in East London today, Alison.
Now, all season is too much ask, because sometimes this game will screw me over, but I will do it as long as possible.
Liverpool. West Ham United's lineup is this. Well, it's 4-4-2.
And another goal is win all my December games. I don't care what I have to do. I am going to win all my December games if it fucking kills me.
He's going to get his message.
I will not have a December draw again.
Coutinho. Nice bit of footwork from the attack.
I can draw in any other month, but this Ember is not an option. I don't care if I draw. I could draw this game in whenever your game, as long as I don't draw in December, I'll be content.
There's always extra excitement, isn't there, Alan, when Cristiano Ronaldo's playing?
Of course, Cristiano Ronaldo looking to win the top goal scorer award back to back, the Golden Boot.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Is it his name? He's the odds are quite against him, actually, because no players won it back to back. Back-to-back years with four different winners now.
Attacking now.
Got a cross. Let's see, Origi.
And he claims the cross.
Origi.
Nothing's ever straightforward.
Neymar, Ronaldo.
He's not been challenged.
Was it Coutinho? Maybe Coutinho. Was it Correa? I will have to look back at that, but I know it's four different people. I know no one has won it twice, so we're back to back. If someone has won it twice, maybe they have. Let's see. Season one was Origi. Season two was.
Well, now they've won the ball back in the middle of the park by intercepting that pass.
Neymar? Or was that season three?
Able to ease the pressure
after a prime. No, I have this strange feeling Coutinho has won it.
Coutinho! A goal for Liverpool.
And he might be on course to win it again because he is getting on and scored the very first goal of season 5. Cristiano Ronaldo probably could have gone unselfish with Ronaldo, but it seems fitting that the captain of the team gets the goals underway. And it's quite fitting that he is number 10 because it is, in fact, 1-0.
Liverpool.
Only it's 0-1. We're not home. The home game against West Ham will happen later in the season.
Neymar.
Probably in January or February. It's a guess and I'll probably be right. March at the latest would be my guess.
Good challenge by West Ham to get the ball back.
Although I don't know fully how this game works. Although I do know how making it 2-0 works with CR7 and the attacking 3-0 are doing damage. But Ronaldo already having a goal and an assist. And the assist
by the replay of the goal
came from Neymar on that goal. If this pattern keeps up, Coutinho will now assist a Neymar goal. That seems to be the early pattern here. I'm not going to try to do that. If that happens, it'll be a pure coincidence. I will be trying to make it 3-0, but I'm not going to go out of my way to make sure it's a Coutinho. Neymar goal assisted by Coutinho.
This is how they love to play on the break.
Here is Neymar. Marco Reus can't keep it in. In fact, he pretty much put it out. It was a very sloppy Marco. Very sloppy. He finished last season on a high
Neymar.
In the Champions League final. Oh, shameless plug there.
Royce.
Huh? Go and watch it. Watch it now. We'll pause this video and go watch it. Or finish watching this video and go and watch it. You know, I've already spoiled the fact that I won it. But you don't know by your scoreline now, do you? Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not going to tell you. Hey, you just know Marco Royce played well and I won. You don't know by how many? You don't know how well Marco played. Did he play well enough to score a hat-trick? Perhaps? Who knows? I know, but I'm not going to tell you. Ha ha!
Noble.
Huh. It's a bitch.
Bitch.
Yeah, you're going to have to find out for yourself. Let's see. The only quote-unquote big teams playing are down to play anyway as City and Spurs are actually playing each other. It's a hell of a first game match. Then again, I can't really say anything because Liverpool have been paired with Arsenal for the first game of the season and then in real life. And preseason. And Liverpool got a taste of reality over in America last night, thanks to Chelsea, which proves who's one thing, that picking on poor or lower league teams doesn't mean you should start or booking the celebration. He ends at any point. And this is why we need to sign more defenders.
Well, here's the goal again.
And wouldn't you know it? It is a Neymar goal, but the assist didn't come from Coutinho. It's come from Mr. Gareth Bale. So the pattern kind of broke. Two strikers and my center attacking mid are all on the score sheet, but they are not all equal on goals and assists.
That's a good challenge.
They're all equal on goals, but Coutinho is lacking it one assist. Now, for all my attacking players to have a go. Well, I need Bale when front.
Toni Kroos has moved to
Royce
Chelsea.
To score, but I'm definitely not going to go out of my way to do that.
Tries to punch it away. He's missed the target by quite a lot in the end. Payet. The goalkeeper with a textbook save and keeps the ball in his grasp.
Also, for those of you who have played a FIFA career mode with a Premier League team and won one of the European competitions, will know that it's after the first game is when the scheduled Super Cup game is. Last season I played it. This season I'm not gonna. It's gonna be skipped. Well, it's gonna be simmed. And with the second team. Not sure why he randomly chose to
Royce.
Shoot last season, but only the important game, only the games that matter will
Royce, punched away by the goalkeeper.
See the YouTube live day, so to speak. So that game will be simmed, of course. You'll see the simulation because it's in between the next game.
Nice idea with the through ball. Didn't come off, though. Sheku Kouyaté.
Actually, don't know who won the Europa League. I didn't actually bother to check that. Normally, I do. Normally, I keep an eye on the Europa League just to see who I might come up against in the Super Cup. Just for the lols.
Now the shot! Terrific stop!
Really, Neymar, you couldn't put that in? How close do you have to be?
To get there first, to find some space, but couldn't apply the finishing touch.
It has been a case of the die being cast pretty early in this football
Dimitri
match.
Payet.
And we've known who's going to win.
Loses the ball, yeah. You have Payet, but he's not any good against this team. Now go, Ricardo. Go.
Here's a cross from
good cross. Oh, Cresswell wins the header against Coutinho, but Bale will send it back in. Neymar, 4-0. Oh, that should wrap it up. The West Ham fans there are distraught. Oh, it was pretty.
It's come in from a long way out. Yeah. From that angle, it's not always easy to finish.
He much set in stone before that fourth goal, to be honest. I mean, they would have had to pull off some major Istanbul-esque comeback to come back from 3-0. Especially with the time that was left before the fourth goal. Especially even more so now with that fourth goal. So, yeah. No good start for West Ham, but they should recover.
Well, they're going to start from the back because it's a back pass to the keeper.
Of course, back in the Premier League because in the game, they're back from after getting relegated. They were out of the Premier League for a season after relegation. They will want to hope that this does not lead to another one. Considering our poor run of form against West Ham in real life, I can't say I'd be sorry to see him go. Sorry, West Ham fans, it's just your form against me and your smugness about it really bothers me. In saying that, we'd be the exact same kind of smug if we were being ye on a regular basis, is when we play G. Yeah, there's a wait, did he reject the contract? Why did you ask for a new one if you were not gonna sign it? Well, I guess I will be making a signing after all. I will be bringing a new second team striker. What do we have here? We have a few noble names. When did I put all these guys on there? I have no idea when I put all these names on here. Who'd be the most useful? You know, I don't want to put an 89 or 90 rated player. Or the, two likely candidates are Aubameyang and Dybala. Yeah, I don't think I'll be signing you. I don't know who you are. I know you're I think that's Totti's region? I'm not sure though. Although that pace. I mean, he'd be really good. A replacement for Origi. If he's gonna refuse, I'm trying to pay him more money and he won't fucking take it. I don't know what's wrong with Liverpool's money. He goes, no, I don't want this money. I want other team money. It's the same thing. You'll still get paid. Nah. Dick. Player sold. Who the hell was that? Oh yeah, Martin Costa to Watford. Oh yeah, heartbroken. It's Valencia. Spanish side? God damn it. Wow, they have a really good strong team. Look at that. A few familiar faces in their lineup as well. Oh, like their left back. Moreno. I wonder who that is. He's playing over Gaia. Yeah, what utter bullshit game. What utter fucking bullshit. We will never live in a world where Moreno is better than Gaia. Moreno isn't better than Gaia now. In real life. Moreno is shit. He's the whole He can see a lot of our goals for us. As he royally screwed us over last season. Just go back and watch that Europa League final and tell me he was not secretly playing for the other team. And another former Liverpool face in the lineup as well. In-game, Roberto Firmino. Busy rating my ex-players there, Ancia. I don't remember selling those players to you. Oh yeah, I actually managed to sell that goalkeeper. I did not think I would, but hell. Yeah, I figured that. They were willing to pay over $100 million, and they were gonna pay 130-something million for Coutinho. But, yeah, I get the feeling Coutinho was looking for a lot of wages. So, yeah, I'll keep my boy. Yeah, and we'll continue kicking ass. Hang on, who? What team was that from again? Well, I'll have to look back over that. Going to the second game. Home game against another team that was out of the Premier League during the last season due to relegation. Back-to-back matches against the newly promoted in returning teams. Interesting start to the fifth season you've put up in front of me game. This time it's a home game against the Eagles, Crystal Palace. I don't know who the third team that were promoted were, but if they're my third game, and I'll just know them if they weren't in the league last season. Big reshuffle. That'd be quite interesting if it gave me the first three games. Americ Laporte as the center back. Hello. I'm sure that's probably happened. Imagine your first three games of the new season, your team are playing the three new promoted teams, you'd be like, oh, for fuck's sake. Because I always dread facing the promoted teams because they're always out to prove a goddamn point.
And
always trying to trip up the big teams. And they almost always seem to work.
And it is about
Kirk against Liverpool. About
him. He's a very unselfish player as well.
He's not what you would call an individual in that once he's got the ball.
I can namely he named Watford in that scenario from last season. As an example.
Be able to switch the play there. Ronaldo! Ronaldo!
Oh, McCarthy can't keep out Cristiano Ronaldo, and he's already 2 for 2.
A celebration by Cristiano Ronaldo. He knows how to work an audience, doesn't he? And he knows how to beat
that poor defensive pass. Yes, that is why you do not pass around the defense. Ronaldo, who shoots to keep her, got something on it, but not enough, because all he did was put it in nicely in the corner. 2-0, fantastic. No, wait, 1-0. I'm looking at how many goals he scored. Ah, game, you confuse me. I'm going to help myself.
Switch the play here. One or two tackles early on. He's given the free kick here. He's going to get his message across the ref. Rafael Varane. Neymar. Hernandez. That's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball. Martin Kelly, and that will be Liverpool's throw-in. Ricardo Rodriguez.
Rodriguez. It's the ball. Ronaldo, can he make it 3-2? Yes, he can. Cristiano Ronaldo out to break. Make records of breaking records.
Got no chance because he's hit it so hard to his right.
No one has
on it here.
Won the top goal score award twice in a row. Cristiano Ronaldo's like, challenge accepted. Straight out of the box, he's got 3 goals in 2 games. 2.5 games, and this one isn't even at halftime yet. It's 20 minutes. game in 20 minutes. Which is, was 1/5 of the way through a match.
That's really well done.
Mariappa does what the only thing he could do to prevent another Cristiano Ronaldo goal is get it out for a corner.
Great work by the goalkeeper.
On the defense, I think it was actually a former Liverpool star. Well, I used the star, her quote there, quite loosely, for Martin Kelly, because he was never really a star at Liverpool. He only, if he was a star, we'd be not sold into Crystal Palace. No offense, Crystal Palace, but
has shown the player a yellow card.
Then again,
be careful now. Fair portion of match to go.
Considering how much Liverpool are saying in real life, it's like a one-team sale over there, or an Anfield.
By the goalkeeper. clasped it to his midriff. Bruno Fernandes.
Especially to Bournemouth. Not sure what Bournemouth want with so many Liverpool players. I say so many, they bought two.
Nathaniel Clark.
Brad Smith and Jordan Ibe. I mean, obviously you think they can get the best of them both.
Martin Kelly. And it's Williams. Bruno Fernandes. James MacArthur.
Laporte gets rid of the ball. Bale will clear it further.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
It's found its way to Cristiano Ronaldo. Oh, Ronaldo kept that in. I was waiting for the referee to, or a corner or a goal kick. I'm not sure what it would have been, but apparently Ronaldo kept that in. It looked like it went out to me. Again, who am I to judge? I'm not a linesman.
Taking the responsibility here. They've just all lost their courage, shrinking into the shells.
And there's the halftime whistle. Crystal Palace are not really enjoying their welcome back to the Premier League, are they?
Second half is now underway.
Did not expect to run into a... I don't think they were expecting to run into an in-form Cristiano Ronaldo. Then again, when you come up against Ronaldo, you should expect him to be in form. So if they weren't, then what were they doing last season? Were they not paying attention? Although, it's not all about Cristiano Ronaldo, as Coutinho scores his second of the season.
That's a nice corner. And didn't he attack?
Marco Royce gets off the ground with his first assist of the season. Normally, actually, I think he's been the top assister pretty much every season. If not him, then it's normally him or Bale. Get those wide man crossing in. A lot of those.
And it's now with Liverpool.
Whose assists come from corners, but that's his first in the second game of the season.
That's going to be a free kick.
Not sure why he didn't get one in the last game, but I guess it just didn't happen. Ooh, McCarthy's lucky no one was there to pounce.
Crystal Palace have a substitute getting ready. Napoli have got their man today. That deal has gone through.
Well, there were a few in for this boy. And this team, in paying around £55 million, made sure they got...
Like, is it to Napoli? That could actually happen in real life, considering Napoli just sold their striker to Juventus.
Maybe once in training, he's put it in the...
That's some crazy-ass shit.
A selfish act.
That's how much Juventus despise competition. They're like, Napoli, they close to opposing us as challengers last season by their best player.
Fernandez.
Why can't Liverpool have that philosophy? He buy the best players of their rivals. Oh, he's good. Let's have him. I mean, what's the point of having so much money if you don't freaking spend it on good players? Fernandez. I want to trust Klopp's signings, but Genie Wijnaldum? Sadio Mane? These are mid-table signings. These are the kind of signings I expect if we'd sold the likes of Coutinho you know, in Sturridge, which we didn't. They're still there. And they'd still play over those two. In fact, Gino Ronaldo will probably not get into our starting lineup. If so, who does he replace? Because for me, I was probably there thinking, hang on a second. I'm still here. I'm your 30-plus-something central attacking midfielder.
One change, and it looks like it's a case of just
I mean, Firmino didn't have a bad season. I mean, you know, it was his first season. I mean, it was his adjusting season.
It's a quick break. Shot on. What a good way to score.
I could see him doing much better this up-and-coming season, getting a handful more goals and assists. But, I mean, if he's going to be... I mean, yeah, it's good to have competition, but... Like, you have so many players who were signed for about the same kind of money. Especially Amlana is probably, like... Hello! I was there way before this dude. As he points at Gene Wijnaldum, who just randomly came in for the exact same fee. Oddly enough, 25 million. It doesn't make any sense. They're strengthening the midfield, even though the midfield isn't what needs strengthening. Why are we not signing defenders? Am I the only one who was paying any attention to our defense last season? As everyone commented on how bad it was. And it was the...
Well, it's very good positional play.
One of the main reason we finished so low. Oh, it wasn't the only reason, but it was the main reason we finished so low. Oh. Yeah, we got a new keeper, we got a few new signings, but it's not good enough. We need a new left back because Moreno isn't good enough. We need two, maybe three more center backs depending on what's going to happen with Mamadou Sakho. Oh, because I don't know what's going to happen with him. He was banned, missed the end of last season, he was sent home from America, he got injured doing nothing apparently. I mean, how useless can you be that you get injured when you're not playing football? I mean, if he got injured in a game, you could understand, you got injured, like, if he had gone to the Euros and got injured, we'd say, oh, yeah, that happens all the time to Liverpool, we're used to it. But no, he didn't even go to the Euros because of that stupid suspension. Which fucked us over. And was dropped. No, I'm not saying Jonathan Tah, especially for that a piss amount. 29 million. Piss off, Malaga. And the fact that they get rid of... Klopp gets rid of Kolo Touré, who was our best defender last season, and by a freaking mile, and then another mile, and then about 10 fucking miles. He was head and shoulders above the other players. He's released on a free, and we bring in some random dude no one's ever fucking heard of. And I'm still waiting for some point to that signing. Is there going to be a point to that sign? Because I'm starting to think there's not going to be. I'm really concerned that there's not going to be. Can you stay at a club and be happy there, okay, David? I'm sick of seeing you move. Sunderland. No, they were in the league last season. And so, I didn't start with the three new teams. Hey, I got the same amount we sold I4 in real life because symmetry and shit like that. So in the next episode, I'll have games against Sunderland and West Brom. In the meantime, I will try and work on getting some signs right. He like, who's going to be replacing Divock Origi. I'll have to figure out what to do about that Ibe situation. I mean, smart money would be just to put Shay Ojo in there, wouldn't it? I will figure that out between his and the next episode, so. But until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel so you don't miss any future videos from me. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.